Hello, I'm Jacqueline van de Bilt, and I'm from the Netherlands, and I'm here with Marta, and we share some experience, and we talked about my own experience of overcoming vaginismus and how important it is that I'm going to share in this video what my road was. So so maybe you find some similar things in my road, especially I want to give you some hope. Because I had the worst vaginismus you can have, and I overcome it, and I can enjoy intercourse and in my whole sex life. So I hope for you also. It started when I was 15 years old. So also for many other women, like when I tried to use some tampons, and it didn't go in. And I asked my mother how to do it, and she tried to explain it, but it felt like nothing could get in. And at the time, it was only a bit difficult, but it was not something I was thinking about. And for when I was about 18 or 19 years, I had my first real boyfriend, and we tried to have intercourse, and it didn't succeed. And in the beginning, we thought it's just because we didn't know anything about it. We didn't do it before with somebody else. So we tried and tried, and every time it didn't succeed again, it felt like somebody was of something was getting some sort of wall, a wall. And I went to the doctor, and he tried to examine me, and that also didn't succeed. And he said, yes, I have the condition of vaginismus. And then I said, what is it? He said, yes, it's a condition. It's in your head. It's a psychological condition. And I thought, what? Psychological condition? But it's something in my vagina is not right because it's closed. And he said, no, it's in your head. And I get some dilators with me and a book so I could do work with the dilators and treat myself. You must imagine that I'm now 53. So it's a long time ago. There was no internet or everything that you can look at anything up. So it's a really different time then. And I went home with the dilators and I looked at them and I thought, okay, what am I going to do with this kind of stuff? Because nothing can get it. So how is this possible? And it's for me, it looks really terrible to let it inside of my vagina. So I tried once and I put them aside and I never used them again. After that, I had a sort of feeling because I really enjoyed having sex, doing all the other things except of intercourse. And I get really, I wanted to overcome it. So I went to all kinds of treatments with also with a group of women. I went and we learned some things about sexuality and how our thoughts are. But it didn't succeed in getting opener and opener. And to make a long story short, I have a lot of counselors I went to, and all they didn't succeed with me. Because when I asked them some questions, for example, to ask, how can I put a finger inside of my vagina? They never explain how. They just say, put a finger in your vagina. And I was so ashamed. Because maybe I was stupid that I could not do that because I knew nobody with the same condition. So I thought I must be the only one who is so stupid that I cannot get my finger inside. So with full of shame, I went away. And then when I go to another counselor, I get sort of the same with another question. I didn't get really good answers. And then when I was much older, I met a friend, just a friend of mine, and she really enjoyed intercourse and really enjoyed sex. And I thought she must know something that I don't know. So I tried to ask her all kinds of questions. And when she explained a little bit, then I asked more details. And so she told me how she let her finger inside of her vagina. She told me how she did have intercourse and how the whole spectrum of things she did and why she loved it, how she felt, what she felt. And she did it with so many details that when we talked about it and I go home, that I'm going to try what she said. And then that step succeeded. And then I asked her for the second step, I asked another questions. And later on in my life, I met my husband. And so when I met him, I could have a finger inside of me. Not easy, but it was possible. And then with her, the way we talked about it, at the end, it succeeded to have intercourse with my husband because of her knowledge of sharing it with me. And I found it so incredibly grateful I am for her to share that kind of stories with me, that intimate stories, because, and I think it's really lousy that so many women don't talk about this kind of things, because it can help so many women when you talk about your sex life, also when you can have intercourse, but why don't we talk about our sex life? So it was, for me, it was, if I look at my courses, it's the courses of, I didn't have any knowledge of my body. I didn't have not a much knowledge about intercourse and how it was. For example, when I was little, I heard really lousy things about intercourse. And in my head, it was like, if it's like that, I don't like it. So I cannot have that in my body. So it was really strict because of the lousy stories I heard. I heard really terrible stories about the first time you have intercourse. I don't know the word in English. So I had really tense in my body. I had really, because of my fear, I need to have the control. So I couldn't let go. And if you cannot let go, then your muscles get like this, like cramped, and also your pelvic floor gets cramped. So it's a combination of causes, and it was a combination of all kinds of things that I overcome my vaginismus. And after I overcome my vaginismus, I thought the first time I succeed, I didn't feel anything. I just looked and I saw a penis inside of me, and I thought, what? How is this possible? And the second time it was the same. So I thought, yeah, now I can have intercourse, but it's not like something that I enjoy. So then I thought again of my friend, I think there must be something possible to enjoy and intercourse. So I looked for all kinds of tips. And I think one of the most best tips I've ever had about intercourse is like that you pleasure yourself, or the husband pleasures also you at the same time as his penis is inside of you, because it's different kinds of feeling you have. For me, it's really nice thing to do. And also to make some contact, because what I found out is that I thought that when people enjoy sex life, they must know something that I didn't know. But what I found out is that now what I like is to be intimate with my husband, to share this intimate moment and to have some contact with them and between us, and how to share what we want and what we need. How you can tell what you want and what you need and what you like and what you dislike, or what can you do for the other one and what can he do for you. And that makes for me that my whole sex life is like, is as nice as it is. So it was really, I was really full of shame during the whole, the whole way I was really full of shame. And now people see me talking about my sex life on television. But yeah, to be honest, I when I was young, I didn't dare to have the word penis inside of my in my mouth. And now when people see me, they say, yes, you're really open about this topic. And I said, yes, but now it's really different. And now I have a mission that when I can overcome my vaginismus, then, and I had the worst kind, nothing could get into it. And the causes are really different causes that that caused it. So now when I overcome it, maybe the other woman can also overcome it. So that's why I love it to hear you talk about how your treatment is. And I love it when we both get success for us just a little bit and for them just so big, because I know the woman who I am now is not the same woman who I was. And you can say, is intercourse so important? Yeah, maybe intercourse is not the most important thing in the world, but it makes me feel more woman, more free, more playful, more whole. I know that when you hear it, there are really big words. And when you don't have vaginismus, maybe you don't understand. But it's not only my words. It's the words of the many women I spoke with. And I always get a bit touched when women say those things, the same as I said, I'm not a whole woman. I'm not normal. I'm full of shame. And I'm always touched because it's the way I felt also. And when you can treat women like what we do, with so much respect and so much gentleness and so much knowledge that we have, and then they can feel more free in their body and in their sexuality and can have intercourse in the whole spectrum of everything you can do, it's a really great thing to do. And then my really lousy road with happy end, if I can say it, was meaningful for so many other people. Yeah. So that's my story. That's my story.
Yeah. Great. Thank you so much for sharing. Yeah. Oh, yes. And you need to give a shout out to your work.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So after I overcome my vaginismus, I'm a counselor for about when I was 19 years old, and now I'm 53. I began to coach women with vaginismus myself, with my own knowledge, and in the meantime, lots of different other knowledge also. And I also wrote my book, like how to overcome your vaginismus. You can buy it on Amazon. And
your website.
My website is overcome your vaginismus. And you can see all kinds of tips. I make little movies with different tips and explanation. You can read something more about my experience, what I did in detail, what my vision is, what my method is. You can look also on the on my website. And if you want the treatment, if you want to have an appointment, feel free to contact me by mail and ask me for the appointment, because if you feel that maybe I could do something for you, I would love to help you.
Thank you very much for doing this. So again, Jacqueline's website, www.overcomeyourvaginismus.com.